Joining us now on the line is Camarines Representative Lray Villafuerte. Good morning, Congressman Villafuerte. Congratulations for getting elected into the House Commission on Appointments.
Thank you, Stanley, and good morning.
Tell us first how big a responsibility lies ahead for you.
Well, the Commission on Appointments is a constitutional body, and we have to fulfill its mandate. First is to ensure public interest is safely guarded, and there's a harmonious...
Congressman Villafuerte?
Sorry?
Yes.
Sorry.
Yes.
And there's a harmonious functioning of the government, no? Of course, it's very important that the government should function swiftly by immediately acting on the nomination appointments of our president, because he has, of course, laid out his priorities, particularly on the economic agenda. So,
right.
We, as member of the majority, we fully support that. However, of course, the mandate is to ensure the integrity, competence, and fitness of appointees are in place. So that's really our mandate.
Okay. Now, you'll be working with Pangasinan Representative Ramon Huico, Cavite Congresswoman Lani Mercado, and of course, Sagip Party List Representative Rodante Marcoleta, among others. Now, have you had a good working relationship with them in the past?
Yes. All of these co-members that I'm going to work with, we worked well in the past. And of course, there's respect among each other's opinion. We are a 12-member team in the House of Representatives. There's also in the Senate. I've also worked with most of the senators in the past in the BICAM. So I think it will be a good composition and a good working relationship.
Yes, the Commission buckles down to work with reviewing all recommendations by the President for various cabinet positions. Please walk us through your timelines and a little bit about the process.
Well, we were just appointed. I think there's going to be a meeting immediately this coming week, and organize ourselves. I'm still waiting for the Senate composition before we can actually convene. However, I think informally, members of the House can meet and immediately, maybe informally, try to work out a schedule on who to prioritize while waiting for submissions of requirements of the appointees. Stanley, first, of course, before we can schedule any consideration of any appointees, is they have to submit the documents required from them.
All right, let's talk a bit more about appointees later. Meantime, a lot of these cabinet positions, as you've said so yourself, need to be filled right away, especially those that are considered vital. Now, how do you ensure exigency at the same time being thorough in going through these nominations?
It's a matter of scheduling and time management. Of course, the nominees are, most of the nominees are already there, particularly in the executive department, not the cabinet. So we have to prioritize that. But again, the submissions of documents is vital before any consideration. But I think most of them have already prepared most of their documents. I think starting next week, buckle down to work as part of the commission on appointments. We have to ensure that the appointees are validated and actually probed as soon as possible. So at least there's already permanence in their position.
Okay, Congressman Villafuerte, now of all the positions and candidates that need to be reviewed, which positions do you think should be top priority based, of course, on the president's priorities?
I think lahat naman, everything is priority. You know, agriculture normally is a priority, but the president is the one handling it. So there's no need to, there's no appointee yet for the agriculture. Education is important. But of course, the vice president being the appointee, there's no actual need to validate that as a courtesy. You know?
Right.
It's in the rules when the vice president is appointed, due consideration is given. To be honest, all appointees are of equal importance. I cannot safely say now who is a priority, but I think they're of equal importance.
All right. And which positions do you think the body will spend more time on in terms, of course, of weight and qualifications? Having mentioned that quite a load has been taken off you because there will be no thorough or no deliberations needed for the Agriculture Secretary position and the Department of Education. So that leaves us with mostly the economic team and perhaps the health team, which are both priorities of the president.
Yes, definitely health's a priority. Right now, there's only an OIC, no? We're still awaiting for actually the final appointment. I think right. Constitutional commission bodies are important, also like the COMELEC. While there's going to be an election in the next 3 years, I think it's important that there should be stability at the COMELEC right now, who's going to head that body.
Okay, now the Commission on Appointments is an independent body. Now, what is the assurance that it will remain such, independent in its task of approving or perhaps rejecting the president's nominees for vital positions? Because it cannot be avoided that this too will be a politically charged undertaking.
Well, that's true. No, being part of the majority, of course, we have to admit that the majority will definitely have to give the appointing authority definitely independent. So there's a presumption that the executive has already probed the competence of all the if there are doubts, it's the objection of the TA to erase those. Definitely would work on that. Independent, of course, each member will be whatever, rest assured of that, Stanley. You know, we individually and as we will definitely vet, validate all appointees. At the end of the day, it is the important thing.
Okay, could you repeat what you said a while ago, Congressman Villafuerte? The line was choppy.
Definitely, each member will have to validate that proof. And we can assure you, each member are highly qualified and independent in mind.
Okay, Congressman Villafuerte, still there? Okay.
Hello.
Hello, hello. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sir, I can hear you. I can hear you, Paul.
Okay, lastly, now, based on the current list of nominees for Cabinet Secretary, is there anyone whom you might think would go through more scrutiny than the others? I mean, Energy Secretary Rafael Otilia's appointment was earlier in question because he's independent director in several energy firms. Then there's also Housing Chief Jerry Acusar, who's facing possible conflict of interest since he's also the chairman of New San Jose Builder. So these complications.
At this point, I cannot comment. No, whatever we read in the media and whatever complaints, it has to be it has to be formally submitted, and we have to validate that. No? It would be unfair for anyone that you focus on them. No? You, I think at this point, everybody will be of equal importance in sophistication. The body has to meet. No? So at this point, we will meet objectively on who are the appointees who should be highly considered to be qualified. And if there are some others, I think it's a forum for them to clear or clarify whatever issues have been raised. But at this point, Stanley, there's no person that that we can pinpoint because at this point we in good we have to declare the nominee to the president.
All right. On that note, thanks a lot for joining us this morning, Congressman Villafuerte, and good luck on your tasks ahead.
Thank you so much. Good morning.
Good morning.